We've been living with COVID-19 for 3 years now. Many of us have had it, some a while ago, others very recently. Some of us may get it again in the future. Today, we're talking about the virus now versus the original variants. While we dig into these topics, we're going to be answering your COVID-19 related questions for about the next 30 minutes. Here to help us sort everything out is Dr. Brent McQuaid, Director of Critical Care for Cone Health. Now, here's how you get your question to him. You're going to text in those questions. We're going to give you the number so that you'll be able to do that at any given time over the next 30 minutes. We're going to be putting it on the bottom of the screen, so it will be on as well throughout the next 30 minutes. 336-379-5775. Your question is anonymous, but you get it answered in real time. All right, so Dr. McQuaid, let's talk about this. Do people who have had COVID-19 still need to get vaccinated and still need to get boosted?
Yes, it's very helpful to do that. Over the last several years, we've seen a change in the way COVID presents. Early on, we know that there was a lot of death, there was a lot of severe illness. And in general, over time, what's happened is that the virus itself has become generally less virulent. So in other words, it doesn't make people quite as critically ill as frequently as it did early, but it's very, very infectious. And what we're seeing is lots and lots of people who have relatively mild symptoms, but there's still some people who come into the hospital who are very sick from it. And there's still a lot of COVID deaths that happen in our community here in Greensboro and the Triad. And so vaccination is a great way to try to keep that from happening.
All right. And so let's say you have had COVID, and how soon after having COVID can someone get that vaccine or that booster?
That's a good question, and we hear that quite often. People say, well, you know, I just had it. Do I need to get it again? Does it add extra immunity? Does it help protect my family from it? And the answer is yes, that it does help to have that. How quickly can you get it? Really, as soon as you can come out of isolation. So once, you know, if you have mild symptoms or if you're asymptomatic, we know that you're supposed to be in isolation for 5 days, and then you wear a mask for another 5 days after that based on CDC guidelines and recommendations. Once you can come out of that isolation period, it's okay to get a vaccine or a booster.
Okay, so, you know, so much has changed since COVID started 3 years ago. I mean, things were changing as it was happening when it all started. How have the treatment options changed since the beginning? So, like, what do you do now if you test positive?
Yeah. You know, since December 2021, early 2022, we've had two oral options that are available. We've had Paxlovid and Molnupiravir, the Pfizer and the Merck products. And this has really changed things quite a bit, made it a lot easier for us to treat patients. You know, prior to that, we had just IV options only. So we would give monoclonal antibodies, we would give a drug called Remdesivir. But now with these options, it's very easy to treat patients as an outpatient with an oral course of these medicines that take about 5 days.
Yeah, and you know, before you were only hearing, you know, us talking about Paxlovid. Now you're seeing the commercials. Got COVID? Paxlovid. But I know that that's not for everyone. So who is able to get that treatment?
Yeah, if you're young and healthy, you know, 22-year-old, non-smoker, no asthma, no medical problems whatsoever, do you need Paxlovid? No, you don't. You know, if you get COVID, presumably, if you're vaccinated, it should be a very mild course, and you'll have the illness and then get over it. And Paxlovid really wouldn't make any difference for you in that sort of a situation. However, where it's beneficial are for those patients who are at risk for getting worse. So who's at risk for getting worse? Those are people who have chronic illnesses. So if you're a 22-year-old who smokes cigarettes and you have severe asthma and you have to use a lot of medication for your asthma, you're at risk for the COVID getting worse and giving you more problems. And so that's where Paxlovid may be helpful. In general, most people who are going to end up getting it are older adults who have chronic medical problems, because that remains the portion of our population that is at the most risk for having severe symptoms of COVID.
All right. And so this has changed to, like, what you do when you are positive. What steps should people follow now if they test positive? Like, how long do they need to stay at home? What do they need to do?
Yeah, so the isolation really hasn't changed over the last several months to year or so. So as I mentioned earlier, you need to isolate for at least 5 days once you've tested positive. You need to wear a mask for 5 days after that. I think sometimes people forget that extra step is that, hey, once you finish those 5 days, it's still a good idea to wear a mask for another 5 days afterwards. But now with these oral options that are available, particularly if you're an adult who is at risk for getting worse. So if you have high blood pressure, if you have kidney disease, if you have diabetes, if you're overweight, if you smoke cigarettes, you really need to speak to a healthcare professional, preferably your primary care doctor, about getting treated with one of the antiviral medicines.
All right, let me just ask you one more question before we head to break. What about if you've just been exposed to COVID? That has seemed to have changed too. Like, what should you do if someone says, hey, you and I were eating together last night and I have tested positive, but you're not showing any symptoms as of yet?
Yeah, you still want to monitor for symptoms at that point. So again, this is happening all the time. You don't need treatment for a very brief window. We had this medicine, this monoclonal antibody that was approved to treat people who had been exposed. It was post-exposure prophylaxis is what it was called. But we don't have that option anymore. And the FDA has only really given us emergency use authorization of these antivirals if you have the illness. So if you're exposed to somebody who's had it, just monitor for symptoms. If you get anything, you know, you get weakness, fevers, chills, by all means, test right away.
Okay. All right. We're going to take that quick break. We've got your text number right there at the bottom. We've already got a few questions in. We'll be taking those when we come back.